but under the purpose of your ignorance of the first thing you worship. Highly PhD, guys, thank you for being religious. Thank you for being so pious. But I want you to know, what a man of God, this is ignorance. The God who created the heavens and the earth and everything that is in the earth does not reside or live in a created things or an idol, because we have our being, we move and we do things because God is alive. He does not live in a temple made with hands. And Paul was talking, I want you to understand that God is not material, idol, or anything that you believe. He is alive. And that's my message to you. There was boldness. Wow! There was no intimidation. Listen to me. When the Holy Spirit is in you, and what the Holy Spirit, but we need power, people who are on the top of accolade and respect and adoration by people, once you speak, they will listen to you because you speak with the word accompanied with power and with the Holy Ghost. See that? Wow. Number two, we can see here, verse 2. Thank you, Samandi. Until the day in which he was taken up after he threw, take note. He was taken up after he threw, the Holy Spirit, the third person of the Trinity, had given commandments to the apostles whom he had chosen. Jesus chose them, and then the Holy Spirit is active in the commissioning of the disciples that God has touched. Number two, the commission Jesus gave to the apostles is a divine order by the Holy Spirit, whom they will receive shortly. So we need the Holy Spirit of a living church. Now the Holy Spirit, listen to me, he is an integral part in the work of the church. Now the word integral here is belonging as part of the whole. In other words, any movement, any word, or any agenda, or any pre-planned things, we must acknowledge God in the Holy Spirit, who is the master architect of the New Testament church. Those who are led by the Spirit of God, they are children of God. The Holy Spirit will teach us and told us he must be acknowledged, and then the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. So when we step, the Holy Spirit will say, this is the direction. Stop there, make a left, make a right turn, and you will say, the power of God moving, because it is not by mind, nor by power, but by my Spirit. The Holy Spirit says the word. So the Holy Spirit is active. And Jesus said, Book of Luke, after showing himself to Mary Magdalene and the first day of his resurrection, another Mary, and then the two men in Emmaus room, and then he showed himself, number two, to Peter, and then to the 11 disciples, and then to Thomas, unless I see that Jesus Christ, I will not believe if Christ show up. And then God show up to those 11 apostles, and then God talked to them, and then under the beach, and then they're cooking, and Jesus showed to them that he ate with them and opened their eyes. For 40 days, God showed his life in person. You can see here. And so what happened? I want you, apostles, as the promise, the grand promise of the Father. Behold, the days come, says the Lord, that I will pour my Spirit upon all flesh. And then, Harry, I don't want to misquote here. Joel 2:28. The promise of God, and then fulfilled in the book of Acts, and it's being fulfilled in our time, and this is our capital to become a vibrant agent for change. This is. Okay, here's the word of God. It will come after all this, the God the Father, that I will pour out my Spirit in all mankind. Amazing. And your sons and daughters will prophesy, foretelling. You can disobey the blood with power, foretelling a word of knowledge of what is going to happen in the inner future, accompanied by the word of God, which is an authority. Then you will prophesy. Your old men will dream dreams. Your young men will see vision. Even on male and female servants, I will pour out my spirit in those days. And Jesus, after resurrection, apostles, followers, yes, Jesus, I want you, don't go anywhere, stay in Jerusalem, and wait for the promise of the Father. They stay behind in the upper room of Jerusalem for 10 days. Because, as it's been promised, wait for the promise until you are covered with the power from on high. In other words, listen to me. They were able to do the work of proclamation, the word of God. They said, Jesus, they can pray for the healing. But what God was talking in the context of waiting in Jerusalem, there is the completeness of the power so he can commission you into the work of God to the maximum. Ordinary people, wait until you are saturated, permitted with my power, and then you will become the witness of the resurrected Christ. God can use Paul and Peter before the power of God came. But now, when the power of the Lord come, what happened to them? Kill them? Cut them? They would say, we rather obey God than men. They are men of courage and authority. You can never, ever shake them. Because the empowerment of God is not outside, it's not intellectual, it's not emotional, it is not cultural, it is not traditional, but from the inside out, nobody can shake you. That's the power. You wait until you are saturated with the power from on high. We need that. Okay, I'll be finishing here for 5 to 10 minutes. If you desire to be a church, and we are, that accelerates and touches so many lives, we need the Holy Spirit in all the work of our ministry. Again, we need the Holy Spirit. Number three, we can see that Christ's resurrection is the foundation of the vibrant church. I tell you already, he showed himself alive. And then, verse 4 and 5, they'll be there. You can see the 40 days there, he showed himself alive, and then 45. And being assembled together with them, he commanded not to depart. You finish that? He stayed there, because the promise will come. And then verse 5.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, there. Verse 5. Okay. For John, take note of this. Jesus speaking. John said, for John to be baptized with water, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit. Not too long from now. Okay. I want you to see this. The number one is the church that can change and make a difference is a church where the foundation is the resurrected Christ. Any foundation that is based in traditions or culture and what we know, thank God for that. And we're not putting them aside. But it must be a church that is founded in the solid foundation of the head of the church. His name is Jesus Christ. If any other foundations that we know to be able to connect to the world, you will fail and you will be tired. But once you proclaim the resurrected Christ that is alive in you, I tell you what, that is solid. Nobody can disqualify you. Nobody can question you. And they can say, that man is different. That woman is different. He's always happy. He's always vibrant. Something is happening. And he was not even rich. He's not bothered. There's such a peace. Because they can see that this man is empowered by God. Two things here you can see. He will baptize. John baptized you with water. And then we'll go this Holy Spirit. Now, baptism of water, by the way, it is an outside or outward sign. Now, we have Bible study to the Indians in Plankton every 10 o'clock in the morning. We have Bible study 6 o'clock to 8, In another planted areas are Filipinos, and in Oco, of course, they are inviting other people. I want you to, what I'm doing now is my wife and me, at the early outset of that Bible study, these are new converts Indian. They are feeding us with Indian food. And I said, you know what? When you believe in he who believes and is baptized, shall be saved. The baptism of water, I explained to them last Friday with my wife, and the Muslim guy is accompanying me now, attending my Bible study, this imam. He is with me there. So we have now Turkish, we have now Indian. No Filipino, just me and my wife. That's all Indian. And in my case, I said, he who believes, and this, okay, after you are converted, to those who believe, there is what they call faith is not here, there must be an action, and is baptized as we say. And I explained to them, baptism has nothing to do with your salvation. You are already a believer, your name is written in the book of life, and God has given you the right to become sons and daughters of God. And I want you to understand that command of the Lord, Jesus Christ, at the age of 30, he came to John during the baptism in the Jordan River, John, would you baptize me? Lord, it is not right. I am supposed to be baptized by you and you are coming to me to be baptized. John, please, allow me, please do this to fulfill the righteousness of God. Jesus himself submitted to water baptism to show to the world, being the firstborn from the dead, every believer, every follower must submit to an outward expression of death to sin and walk in the newness of life. And the Bible says, after he got out of the water, Jesus, the windows of heaven was open, and there was a voice of the Father, this is my beloved Son in whom I am well pleased. And then a Holy Spirit in the form of a dove come to Jesus Christ in his shoulder, and then John saw this. And I explained to them, once you're baptized in water, it has nothing to do with your salvation, your sin. That is a testimony, listen to me, of water baptism. As Jesus Christ was buried for 3 days, the moment the pastor submerges you underwater, with the sincerity of your heart, you're talking to the Lord. Everything that is defiled, everything that is that good, ugly in my heart and my attitude, the things I used to live daily, have people saying, God, forgive me, God, forgive God. The moment I'm submerged to water, all the things that are creeping inside of me, I want them to bury with you. Boom! I don't like that, I hate that, I rebuke that. And once you get out of water, as Jesus resurrected from the grave with incorruptible body, because that body is incorruptible, in the same token, Paul said, when you get out in that water baptism, which is a symbol of death to self, when you got out of water, you have to walk in a newness of life, new beginning to the opposite. Going to destruction, hell, and all the characteristics of the worldly people, you will make 180 degrees, slowly, surely, moving forward to follow the model of your faith, Jesus Christ the Lord. And after that, you need the baptism of power. So the first one is baptism of water, identifying yourself to die with Christ. Get out of water to walk with a new way of life. Understanding, projection, desire, ambition, heaven reward, not more in the earthward pleasure and gratification of the 5 senses of your physical body. Okay, I'll finish here now. And lastly, I'll expand here next time. Baptism water, what we need is baptism of the Holy Spirit. So, today, our baptism, I teach in plankton baptism, I'll be teaching another plankton baptism, and then, you know, in Rose Hill and Riverstone, we have the meeting last Thursday, about 11, and to my joy, and David is a very faithful disciple of the Lord, and Simon, God, the mother said, Pastor Ganny could not come because I don't feel well. Elisha and Pam was there, the part that I can foresee as I decide for them the real practical application of the teaching in a certain digital group, Riverstone, Rossing, this is a church or a group of people that will make the difference. I encourage some of you, because most of these people are really grown up in Hillsong. I'm teaching them the practical side. So I teach deeper teaching in the real presentation. Come every Thursday, 6:30 to 9. And then I'll show you how, and Simon is get ready. We'll do something Simon and Riverstone. And then in Rose Hill Church, you know what? This is a church that God is envisioning to happen. The quality of the church of people manifesting or sharing the word of God or testimony is accompanied with secular nature words of God. Number two, it is a group of people that is empowered by the Holy Ghost, who is baptized and baptized with the Holy Spirit, where God entrusts something. The church that is vibrant and powerful, when everyone of us is filled with God, and then we start to do the work by sharing Jesus Christ. That's the start. And we can begin to expect that the church is a church that will make the difference. Not inside here, it's not. These are all celebration and fellowship. The real manifestation of the church of God is in the marketplace, where people can see that the resurrected Christ is alive. They can see it in you. And once you talk to them, they'll be interested. Listen to me. And when you pray for them, I think their this is coming to pass. When you pray for them, they will be saved and they will be healed. So they cast out lots of people, rivers of people, some of this are becoming. They will experience that. And David and Pam is here can attest that we will be doing it. And you'll see the power in action. We'll continue to expand church. That's the vision. We'll be seeing churches planted in the different sober of Latin. It started our hearts to be serious and Lord. I am a person on a church, an instrument, oh Lord, a vehicle that can make the difference. Make me that one in Jesus' name. Happy Father, thank you.